Guys, so we're doing a chest and shoulder workout today. We will need a mat for some floor exercises, and I'm going to work with 10s today. So get two weights. If you need to have like 8s or 5s sitting by, just in case you need to drop down later on into the workout, then go ahead and do that. All right, so have your water nearby as well. We're going to go into full-on jacks, or you can modify. So those of you who can do advanced, otherwise, we're gonna step out to the side, alternating, raising your arms up. It's not doing anything less to modify. You're still moving, you're still getting your heart rate up. Most of this today is gonna be timed. So go at your own pace and do what feels comfortable for you. All right, so go ahead and rest it out here. I want you to do opposite arm, opposite leg. We're just opening up the shoulders, opening up the hips, getting your hamstrings loosened up. I have a shoe that's untied. Here. I'm going to throw those off and work out barefoot. Okay, so we're going to take those arms back and do a butt kick as well. So open up your chest. Again, go at your own pace. I'm going to be timing these so you may get 10 reps in, you may get 15. Totally depends on each side of your body. And if you really need to watch your form, then you're gonna go a lot slower.
And there are tons of vendors, and it's all about getting you healthy and in shape. And I got really excited because I came right over to Sky Zone Trampoline Park. Bree and Mark are hanging out over here, and I was like, Mark.
And let's release. Okay, I think we should be good and warmed up. I'm gonna go ahead and we're gonna grab one weight to start with, okay? So we're gonna do a clean press here. What you're gonna do is you're going to stick your butt back a little bit, curl up, press, and come back down. So you stick your butt back, curl, press. Keep going. So your butt goes back on this, and you're keeping a nice flat back. So I want your eyes down towards the floor as you take that weight down, keeping it close to your body, close to your legs. Going to switch sides here. Other side. I like to put my hand behind my back because it helps me to make sure that I'm keeping my hips square and I'm not twisting or rotating. Keep that chin retraction. Trying to keep a flat back here. All right, bring it down. All right, we're going to go into a squat. So we're gonna pulse for two down. Hold that weight in front of you. One, two, come up. You're gonna hold that weight up, jack in for two. And down for two. This one I'm gonna show modification. You're gonna step it in, step it out. Come back down for two. Come up, jack it in for two. Back down for two. Come up, step it in, step it in. Down for two, up. Two jacks, if you can do jacks. If you have a hard time, you're just gonna do two step outs to the side and go down into your squat pulse. You can sit back into a chair or back into your couch if you need to. Come down and let you get a little bit of a breather here. We're gonna rest just a little bit. And grabbing a sip of water. Okay, so this one, as I show you, is several steps. Reverse lunge, cross punch, come together, arms down, upright row. We are staying on this leg. Come together, alternate, upright row. Reverse lunge, cross punch, both arms, come together, upright row. All right. Have a hard time with lunges, it's okay. You can just do a step back if you need to. Make sure you're getting your balance really good. Almost there. Cross punch. Go into your upright row. You can tell we're doing a lot of shoulder activity today. We're going to get into the chest in just a little bit. One more reverse lunge. All right, if you feel like you need to drop set your weights, you can do that now because we have the other leg to go into. Reverse lunge, cross punch again, come together. Alternate, upright row. All right, so I have my shoes off, mainly just because my shoe got untied, but it is actually good to work out barefoot if you can do it, because it helps to work all of those muscles in your feet and you're able to spread your toes out. And really get a nice stable base. So if you have trouble with balance, it might actually be good for you to work out without shoes on. If you have a slippery floor, I would go barefoot without socks. Let's go one more. And come together, upright row. All right, let's set that weight down for a second. Go ahead and grab some water. We're gonna be down in a push-up next. I want you to have your cushion for your knees, most of all, okay? So, I'm gonna show you sideways here while you're taking a little breather. We're gonna do these push-ups on your knees. You're gonna have one weight, okay? And it is behind your hand. Squeeze your butt, go down into your push-up, come up. Grab that weight and drag it to the side. Then you go into your push-up again. Go ahead and join me if you haven't already and drag that weight. Drag to the side. You don't have to go all the way down to the floor in your push-up. If you don't have the range of motion, that's okay. Or if you have wrist problems, go into a fist. Push up, come up, and drag. If you need to do this at a higher surface, or if you just need to do push-ups on the wall and not have this weight drag, you can change it up. Meet your body where it's at. I'm sliding a little bit. legs are sweaty. And release. That was awesome. Okay. So we're gonna go ahead and come back up. We're gonna be on the floor in just a second again. So we're gonna take the weights. I'm gonna actually drop down to eights here. We're going into a lateral lunge, so a side lunge. So go side lunge, take that weight with you. Come up and press up. Side lunge. So you can stay in this tapped toe position, or you can come up and do knee up and work on your balance. So if you need to stay down here, you can. Or you can take it up and challenge yourself. Further you lean into that side lunge, the more your glutes have to work to get you up. Alright, here we're gonna switch sides and go to the other side. Side lunge, bring it up, tap it down if you need to. Make sure your knee is staying in line with that middle toe. You guys are doing great. Woo. Almost there. We're gonna get this one in. And then drop those weights down. So we're gonna do a bridge with a chest fly. So grab the weights, that is gonna feel good. Doing a fly, I'm gonna come at an angle here. So down on the floor, nice flat back, chin retraction here, push your chin down to the floor, up in a bridge, take those arms out to the side with a slight bend in your elbows. If you notice that your hips start to drop, squeeze your butt and lift them back up. And last one, bring it up. Set those weights on the floor, roll to the side to come up. We're gonna take a little rest here. We're getting a sip of water. All right. So we're gonna pick it up here. One weight, sorry. One weight. So we're gonna do clean press again. Squat that back, curl, press, and bring it back again. Nice flat back. Keep that chin retraction. Switch hands, go to the other side, flat back, put that hand. hand behind your back if you need to. Take that weight. We have two pulse squats with those jacks, or modify if you need to. Two pulse down, come up, jack it in. Remember, if you need to modify, you can come up, step it out, squat back down. Take your time with it. I don't want you going so fast that like you hurt your back or anything like that. Modify if you need to. I'll do it with you here. Just as a reminder, anytime you feel like you need to stop and catch your breath a little bit. Release. Feel free to grab some water if you need to. We're doing that lunge. I'm going to grab the eights this time around. So reverse lunge, left leg. Reverse lunge. Cross punch each side, come together. Alternate. Upright row. Going right back into it. You don't have to keep up with me. You need to slow it down, and then go ahead and slow it down. Almost there. Do one more on this side. All right, go right back into that right leg back. Cross punch, upright row. I'm sure your arms are getting tired. If you need to switch out your weights, do it quickly, but keep moving. Remember your breathing. We're almost there. This is your last upright row. All right. Awesome job. Okay. So we're going to come back down to your push-up here. So go ahead and take it down to the floor. Make sure that you're in a good position with your knees and that your butt's not up in the air, but you bring your pelvis forward, squeeze your booty for me, do your push-up, come up, drag that weight to the side. Again, if you need to be on your fist, then go on your fist. If you need to take this to the wall, just go ahead and take it to the wall. Make sure your hands are underneath your shoulders. I'm sliding a bit, so keep going back a little bit. Last one. Drag that weight and come up. Get yourself a little bit of a breather. I'm going to grab these weights as I come up. We're going to do that side lunge, press, okay? So, side lunge, come up, you can do the knee up with the press. Last one. Here. Go ahead and switch it out. And we're going to the other side. Hang in there with me. We have one more exercise after this to end this set. And you can take a little bit of a breather and grab some water. Almost there. Last one here. Take it down. Push up into it. All right. Going down to the floor here. Come on your back. Grab those weights. You're going to go up into a bridge. Weights are up. Hold that bridge up. Fly. Out to the side. Exhale with that lift. Pick that booty up. One more fly for me. Lower your butt down. Drop those weights, roll to the side and come on up. We're gonna do one more round of that. Okay. A bit of a breather. Pause if you need to. We're going clean, press. The last round, you guys. All right. Switch hands from here. Just go right into it, other side. Holler at me if you feel like your back ever hurts with anything, or your knees. Any other body part, if something's bothering you during an exercise, then let me know. And last one there. All right, pulse squat to jacks. Ready? Pulse it down for two. Come up, jack it in, back down, right into it. Up and jack. Down for two. Modify as needed. We're almost there. You've got one more here. And up. And then go ahead and bring it down. All right. We're swapping out. Catch your breath. Left lunge, reverse back, cross punch. Bring it in. Alternate. Upright rows. This isn't as much intensity. So take this opportunity. Just take your time with it. Get a nice deep breath in. Nice breath in through your nose. Long exhale through your mouth. All right, you guys. Switch it here. Right leg back. Cross punch. Bring it in. Alternate sides. You guys, we're almost there. Don't give up on me now. Taking it down to the floor for your push-up drag. I'm actually just gonna go down on carpet this time. All right, that weight's behind your hand. Tuck your pelvis down into your push-up. Drag that weight to the side and push-up. Exhale as you push up. Chin retraction as you're standing up nice and tall. Remember, you can tap down here if you need to. One more on this side. Feel like you need to drop set your weight. That's totally okay. Going into that side lunge, curl press. As long as you don't feel like you're straining your neck, you should be okay with your weights. I'm sure you're feeling a burn by now. That's completely normal. And last one to the side. Keep your weights. Drop it down to the floor here. You're going to go into your bridge, raise it up, and go into your fly. Squeeze your butt, chin retraction, push that chin down to the floor. Two more. Last one. All right, take it down. Drop those weights. Come come on up for me. So that show is about, we're going to reach to the side, a 270 total calorie burn for this workout. So you can kind of measure. Sure, I could have given it a little more effort or done a little bit heavier weights on some of the things. So next time that I do it, I will probably, let's switch sides, go up in weights on a couple of the exercises that I know I can. And that will also help to challenge your body. If you're stuck in a plateau, there needs to be changes that take place. It's either the intensity of your exercise by how you're doing the exercise or the amount of weights that you're using, or I mean the size of the weights that you're using. So look at those things. If we're gonna go forward, if your joints can't take going down deeper into a lunge, or you know, you have a hard time with the balancing, then add heavier weights. I'm sure you feel like you have a burn while you're exercising. That's completely normal. But challenge yourself at the beginning of the workout to do heavy and then drop down to lighter weights as needed. All right, bring it in. I'm gonna do an inner thigh stretch. Nice deep breath. Exhale. Relax your shoulders. Push those knees down to the ground. All right, you guys, you are all done. You did amazing today. Treat yourself to a nice like foot soak, soak in a bath, pamper your muscles to help you recover easier. Thank you so much for joining me.